I'd like to introduce you to my good friend, Derek Seaman, and more importantly, in this context, one of the best builders that I happen to come across in my travels in North America. Derek, you've been building in this town for a long time. Tell us a little bit about Seaman and Sons.
We're a third generation builder located in Southampton. Grandfather started our company in 1954. My dad and my uncle took over in the 70s and have since both retired. I've been full-time since 2002, so we've built a lot of our 2000 homes through from the 80s into the 90s and even to today. Focus on energy efficiency and quality building.
I want to talk about this particular project. You had built this house for us in 2015. That was your first NetZero location, as I recall.
It was. We'd done a lot of R2000 houses, but this was our first registered NetZero.
Right. And for those who don't know, R2000 was Canada's historic energy efficiency program, started in 1982. And it was designed as a technology transfer program to help builders understand and appreciate the value of better construction. And now our minimum building codes in this area are pretty similar to what those concepts were in 1982. And now it's time to take it to the next level called Net Zero. And Derek, when you and I first talked about this project, I think we sat down and talked about 30 different technologies that we wanted to try.
Yeah, and then we used quite a lot of them. I don't know if we got exactly to 30, but there was quite a few, and this was a lot of fun as a builder to build a project like this where you get to try so many new things, and it went really well, and the house turned out to be very, very airtight, and it went really well.
That's one thing you're proud of, because I know over the years, your dad's house, I remember testing it back in 1987, and it was 0.33 air change per hour at 50 pascals, which for those who don't know, well, those on this video, watching this video, probably do know what that means. Imagine in 1987, I think it was?
86, yeah.
86, down at 0.33, pretty phenomenal, but we need to tell them what this house came in at.
This house came in at 0.19, I believe.
Right.
At 50.
Yeah, so we immediately phoned your dad and told him.
Yeah, he was in Florida at the time.
But yeah, exactly.
We called him to have bragging rights.
And what else in this project do you recall being, I would say interesting or a challenge for him?
There was a lot of different things. The construction was a little different than we'd done, especially on the roof. There was a lot more insulation, exterior sheeting on the roof, which we hadn't done a lot of before, other than in timber frame type style buildings. So there was a few challenges but it makes the whole project for me a lot more interesting and keeps me interested. It just overall, more excited about the project, lots of new things.
And it is a concept we're going to talk about in this video and then in future videos, is this idea of effective R values, understanding that wood frame construction, the cavities are pretty good from an insulation perspective, but the studs themselves, there's a lot of thermal bridging. And so you have to counteract that by, well, either building two walls, double walls, which you probably your dad did back in the day.
Yeah, we've done them not a whole lot. They're quite a lot of extra labor and loss in space. So
right. So then we've gone to insulated sheathings, but as we just mentioned, they have their challenges as well. But we're going to show that on the garage, the bunkie. We're doing a bunkie on this project, and that'll give us a chance to show that technology as well. In fact, a new product from Amvic called Silverboard, which gives us an opportunity to get to that higher insulated sheathing levels in still a vapor permeable product. Derek, I wanted to just on this video kind of help folks understand some of the design choices we made, or I would say technical choices. You and I always banty that back and forth of the building science guy and the builder, what's buildable, what works. And one thing, you know we did in this house, but also the new project, we talked about slab on grade construction.
Yeah.
I always like to make the point, you always make the point, sand's really good at drainage, which it is. But sand, it also really has a lot of capillary flow, water coming back up. So I like the concept from a durability, resiliency point of view of no basement. You're comfortable with that at this point?
Yeah, absolutely. Being that close to the water too, it never hurts to be up a little higher as well. So.
And I've seen many of the projects you now do on the lake are at least portions of it, most of it slab on grade.
Quite a few of them are, depending on the distance back from the lake and where the water table's at on the lot.
So I just wanted to highlight some of the architectural features. You can imagine world-renowned sunsets. Cooke family's gonna wanna watch those from multiple different levels, watching the beach. So the design concept is very much about windows on the west face. Of course, that's a concern because, especially in the winter, but even in the summer, those winds are just howling. So Derek, let's talk a little bit about the choices that we've made here. First floor on those large sliding patio doors.
Yes, we went with lepage patio doors, triple glaze with low solar heat gain coefficient glass. trying to prevent the main floor and then second floor from getting cooked on in the summer. So we went with those windows. There are a few challenges with having that much glass. There's not a lot of ICF wall left, to be honest. It does limit the amount of wall left, so that was a bit of a challenge engineering-wise. But I think it turned out great.
I agree. Looking at the design, you know, it's going to be a really nice concept. You know, the patio, and people are going to say, well, it's covered by a patio or by a balcony. You're not going to have a problem with solar gain, but that sun's coming in basically flat, right, in the evening.
It does, yeah. 6 o'clock till 9 o'clock, it comes directly into that.
Directly house. In. And it's kind of interesting because that's exactly the time we were thinking about going indoors, getting comfortable. People always talk about on the lake, not needing air conditioning. And generally that's true because of the breezes, but you just don't want that heating up in the evening.
Yeah, that's definitely the case. The low solar heat gain glass will definitely make a big difference there.
And I was a little concerned about the size of those doors, 8-footers, and I think they're 8 foot high as well. Lepage seems to, and you've had good experience with them.
We have, yeah. We've used quite a lot of their products and gone a lot wider than that too in the lake.
Even wider?
Yeah, we've gone up to 22 feet wide.
Oh, wow.
So, and they've been a great product, and they're very airtight. So.
Yeah, that's always our concern, right? You see, you'd always said to me the French doors, the center French doors, really difficult to make.
Yeah, in swing doors on the lake with the wind pressure are very problematic, so we try to avoid them facing the lake.
Right, and then second floor, you know, that's where the bedrooms are, and we'll have that really nice balcony that folks can be on. Snow load in the wintertime. We won't be there much in the winter, but snow loads, how are you feeling about that?
I think the engineers did a nice job. We have a very large beam coming across to hold up the entire deck. A lot of structural steel built inside the structure, so I think that'll be great.
And then in terms of slope and so on, just get that water away.
Yeah, we'll put an inch or two of slope on that balcony and then drain it off the west face.
And then some of the features we'll want to see in future videos is the detailing of the sill around the windows. You and I are great fans of the DuPont Tyvek system. You've been using it for years. Your experience?
Yeah, it's been great. And again, with the construction instruction, we were able to test that system with their different flex wraps and straight flashes. So we've had a lot of good luck. We don't have any issues with windows leaking, doors leaking, anything like that. So which is especially important when you're getting the kind of wind-driven rain, especially on the west face of this cottage.
Right. So. And then lastly, I'll mention again, we talked about it earlier, about the steel roof. Again, you've had good experience?
Yeah, on the roof, there are a lot of issues in this town on shingles blowing clean off of the roofs. We see it quite often. So this steel roofing, I'm very confident that's going to stay there for a long, long time.
Beautiful. It's fairly low slope, but we're not worried particularly. Raised heel truss, should be fine for that.
Yeah, we should be fine. We use the proper underlays that they recommend, that the manufacturer recommends for that low slope applications. Yeah, I think it's going really well, so I think it's going to be a great cottage for a lot of generations.